Hello, 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 Monday afternoon. Hopefully you're having a great start to the week. You've had a great Monday. I've been up since 3 a.m. this morning. I'm currently in Melbourne. I'm in my hotel room down here in Melbourne, down with my national client for the next 3 days this week. Look, what I wanted to talk about tonight was the fact that you need to act on the things that you've learned. So as you know, last week I was fortunate enough to go to the Gary Vee event in Brisbane. Look, I don't want to make this about that event. Rather, I was reflecting on my plane trip down this morning that plenty of people go to those sorts of events, those keynote speeches. They might go to Tony Robbins. They might go to a whole range of other motivational people. The key with all that is that when you take away from those particular events, what are you going to do next? Okay? What is it that you're going to do? There's an old Chinese proverb, which is to know and not to do is to not know at all. That is that just because you know something, if you don't act on it, if you don't put it into practice, then what's the point in the first place? Tony Robbins talks about the old saying, which is knowledge is potential power. So I grew up with the saying of knowledge is power, but he actually talks about that knowledge is potential power. And it's potential power because just because you know something doesn't mean that you can go and act on it. And so that's the key. You must go and act on whatever it is. G'day, Josh. How are you, mate? You must go and act on whatever it is that you're doing. Josh, I'm just talking about events, keynotes, etc. Not about Gary Vee specifically, but I'm talking about when people go to those types of events, they walk away, they're all hyped up, excited, motivated, and then a few days afterwards, they come crashing down and they don't go and do the things that they've been taught. And that is the key for me. And so there's a Chinese proverb, which is, and I mentioned it before, which is to know and not to do is to not know at all. And so if you go to a Gary event or a Tony Robbins event or other motivational speakers, and you don't act on the stuff that you've learned, then you effectively haven't learned at all. That is the key. And I was reflecting on the plane trip down this morning, just how many people go to those events and actually don't do anything about it. The key is to execute. The key is to take the learnings away and start to work on whatever it is that you need to work on. You know, don't kid yourself that by going to a whole range of courses, you're actually taking yourself closer to your goal. You know, I'm certainly not knocking going to courses, and I'm certainly not knocking getting knowledgeable about things. G'day, Brendan, how are you, mate? I'm certainly not knocking getting knowledgeable about things, but at some stage, you've got to put into practice all those things that you are learning. You've got to start putting that left foot in front of the right and move your way forward. It's no point just going to courses, course after course after course. And I come across so many people who go to course after course after course and convince themselves that they're moving their life forward. Again, I'm not knocking knowledge, I'm not knocking education, but you've got to start to put into practice those things. Don't be a course junkie and keep going to courses and not do anything about it. The key is that you've got to be able to, Josh is saying, standing in front of the barbecue, cooking a rack of lamb, listening careful. Mate, terrific. Thank you. Really appreciate it. G'day, Russell. How are you, mate? Hopefully you're going well. Look, I'm doing this live from Melbourne. I come down to Melbourne every second week. At the moment, I've got a national client down here, and I come down and do a little bit of work to help them out from a sales and coaching perspective. So here I am outside of my hotel room, but I was reflecting on the plane this morning coming down, that I've just gone to that event, Gary Vee's event last week, and I was just questioning to myself how many people actually don't do anything about it. You know, I think about myself. I mean, I've come out of that event, I'm even more motivated now than I was before the event, if that's possible, and I'm all fired up, and I've been doing a whole lot of stuff over the weekend, got a whole lot of stuff planned for tonight, etc. So I'm really fired up, but I just wonder how many people actually don't do anything at all, but yet convince themselves in their mind that they're moving closer to their goal, they're doing something. It doesn't even have to be an event. I'm on a busy road here, so hopefully you can hear me. But it doesn't even have to be an event. It could be people who are, you know, constantly reading books or constantly listening to podcasts, etc. I'm not dismissing education. You know, please don't get me wrong. I'm all for education. I listen to podcasts myself. I read a lot of books. But at some stage, you've got to be able to put into practice all those things that you learn, and you've got to stop convincing yourself that just because you're reading, just because you're educating yourself, just because you're listening to a podcast doesn't necessarily take you closer to your goal. Hello, Fee, how are you? So it's all about not knowledge is power, but knowledge is potential power, as Tony Robbins says, and then it's about putting that knowledge into practice. whether it be through books, through podcasts, through courses, through events, through keynotes, whatever it is, put all the things that you learn into practice. That's the only way that you're going to get better. The other piece with all that is you've got to start. At some stage, you have to start. I get that when you're trying something new, it can be quite fearful, it can be daunting, there's a whole lot of uncertainty, but you've got to start. You know, you don't. The way in which you start isn't necessarily the way in which you finish. And a lot of people try and get everything lined up very perfectly and make sure that everything's lined up and they get a beautiful business card and a beautiful this, etc. It's like, just get into it. Just lean into whatever it is and start. You're going to make mistakes, fumble along the way. I've made so many mistakes and continue to make mistakes. But of course, mistakes is where the growth happens. You know, mistakes equals learning, and learning equals growth. So you've got to start. So you've got to go to these events or listen to your podcast or read your books. But then from there, you've got to put into practice all of the things that you learned. And through the practice, you'll become better, you know, a better practitioner. And you'll work things out along the way. You'll iron out a few chinks. You'll overcome those mistakes that you've made, etc. But at some stage, you've got to lean into that fear, and you've just got to start. So, look, it's a little bit of a, you know, my thoughts today. As I said, I was thinking about this on the plane this morning. But it's all about, by all means, go to the courses. But please don't convince yourself that by going to all of these courses that you are necessarily progressing closer to your goal. Then you've got to put something into place. Josh says, no plan B, Tony. Absolutely, you know, absolutely. So by all means, go and do something at the, you know, take on board the knowledge, but then work out what is it that you're going to do to move forward. Make the mistakes. You know, you might head down a particular path and realize that it's not necessarily for you. For example, for me, all I wanted to be was a property developer, and that's all I wanted to do. And whilst I like property development, it's not something I necessarily love, but I like it. But what I love doing is I love coaching people. And so through property development, I discovered that I actually had a love of coaching. And so that was my alternative thing. But I only got that through having a go at property development, working out what it is that I liked, what it is that I didn't like, and then following my heart down the particular path that I find myself today. So look, as I said, just a bit of a you know, my view on a Monday evening down here on a busy Melbourne road in a Melbourne suburb. Just wanted to update and say, hey, by all means, get educated, go to courses, but please, please, please put into practice all the things that you've learned. That's the only way that you will truly get closer to your goals. Thank you. Josh says, love the message. Thank you, mate. I really appreciate your support and listening to me. Hopefully the rack of lamb on the barbie works out great, mate. So thank you, everyone. Have a great night. Bye for now.